Hi everyone, my name is Dai Excel, your Excel Sifu from YXL. In this video, we are going to see how we are able to calculate the penalty due based on the due date and based on the total months plus the remaining of the days in the month. So if let's say the due date is on the 1st of January of 2019, the penalty calculation is 1st of January of 2020, it will be exactly 12 months with the 3% of the 12 months of 100,000, that will be 36,000. If let's say I would change this to the 1st of January 2019, so it will be exactly no overdue. If let's say I will change to the 2nd of January 2019, it will be 1 day overdue with the penalty. Let's see how this thing works in the next worksheet. The first one, we will have the amount due, we have a due date, we have a penalty percent per month, we have penalty date. The intention we have this thing by individual role is we have a greater flexibility. If I say in your context will be the same, you just need to adjust it accordingly. The very first step, we want to calculate the penalty amount for each one of the situation and based on the percentage. So just equal the amount due multiply with the penalty percent per month. So I get this thing over. And to get this formula downward, we just go to the bottom right of the active cell and double click. And this view handler able to copy this formula downward. The next thing, we want to calculate number of months late. With this simple hidden formula, we are able to calculate this easily. That formula is equal date leave, open parenthesis, the starting date will be from due date, comma, until the penalty date, and comma, I want to know the number of whole months in between them. So we use double quote, M, and close double quote, and close parenthesis, and enter. This is exactly 12 months. To double check this formula, we just go to bottom right and double click. You will see the whole thing changes. When it is less than a month, it will be zero. So this formula works perfectly. The next thing, we want to know number of remainder days late. It will be equal, date again, and open parenthesis, from the due date, comma, until the penalty date, and comma, and now we want to know double quote, remainder day, and close double quote and close parenthesis. This MD will indicate number of days late, excluding the year and excluding the month. So we just press enter. This one exactly 12 months, so it doesn't have any remainder. So we just double click on the field handler. So you will see the towards the end of the year, the 31st December is 1 day before 1st of January. So exactly is 1 day. So this formula works again. And based on this one, the remainder day late, we want to calculate the prorate based on the month of the last penalty date. So we want to get equal day tab end of month tab of the penalty and comma end of the month of the same month will be zero and close two parentheses, it will return 31st. That means it will be 31 day in the 1st of January. That means in the month of January. Okay, double click and copy this whole thing downward. To double check this formula, if I change the month instead of January, I change it to February to 2020. You will see the value changes to 29. Means in the year 2020, the February is a leap year. So it has 29 days. So this formula works. Let me undo to reverse checking. And this thing, finally, we want to know the prorate. This one is not prorate yet. So just continue modify this. And before the day, we want to know the remainder day divide by the total days of the last month. So you see this thing changes to the date because it presumes this is the date. So in actual fact, it's not. So we just go back to home, make sure we change the formatting from date to general. So you have this thing ready and go to the bottom right few hundred and double click. You will see it has a fraction, that means in a decimal. So it works perfectly, and this is more than half a month, and this one is lesser than a month. So I want to calculate total penalty. Total penalty will be equal of the total months late plus the fraction of the month for the remainder day. We want to close bracket for these two because we want to sum them up before we multiply with the penalty amount for month. Press enter. So in a month of in 12 months for the penalty of 1,000, there will be with the interest of 3%, there will be total of 36,000. So this works perfectly. We just go to view handler and double click and copy it downwards. So this formula simple sequence is able to help you to do the calculation based on the amount due and the penalty date. So this will be a little bit more, however, it provides you greater flexibility. If you like and benefiting from this video, please like and share this video to your friends and colleagues so they are able to benefit from this video as well. My name is Star Excel, your Excel Sifu from YXL.